Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. Let's get talking about last week's Invitation of the Nine. Sorry that I was a little late to the party on this one. I've been prepping to go to America, and I was also moving things from my old office to my new place. Side note, sound quality on this one is one that will be a little different because you're actually listening to me from my new office for the first time. Adjustments will come as time goes on, but for the moment, this is what you're getting. Super thrilled to have this dedicated new space, and yeah, it's really phenomenal to work in. It already feels like a tangible difference from being in a single room where I was also sleeping. So thank you so much for all the help on letting me get to that. This is all as a result of your incredible support of my YouTube career. So kudos to you guys. I can now sleep properly and I can work in a better environment. Thank you. Anyway, before we get into this invitation, and what it really is, let's get into what it isn't. I originally did a script on this invitation, and I originally ran the invitation on my hunter, who is notably an awoken female guardian, and as a result, I got this dialogue. Take a listen.
What does it want?
Power.
You.
No one is my kind.
We don't understand.
She has agency like you wouldn't believe. She can leave this place.
This place? We can leave this place.
Think bigger. She can leave this game.
We don't understand.
Then I'm afraid it's impossible to explain.
Now, when I heard the pronouns her and she, I was convinced that this was a whole-ass Savathun reference, especially the notion of she can escape this game and the meaning of the tarot card that we got this week. I believed that this was all a reference to what she was accomplishing within the Truth to Power cards, if they're to be believed, and all the while I sat here in great fear of committing terrible Imbaru by simply uttering her name. Whilst all of it was an accurate interpretation of what was going on with Savathun, it was not an accurate interpretation of the actual invitation this week, and why? Because I did it on my female hunter first. Replaying it on my male warlock gave me a slightly different result.
What does it want?
No one is like him.
We don't understand.
He has agency like you wouldn't believe. He can leave this place.
This place? We can leave this place.
Think bigger. He can leave this game.
We don't understand.
Then I'm afraid it's impossible to explain.
So needless to say, scratch the Savathun theory. We're going to talk about the invitation correctly, and we're going to talk about Destiny breaking the fourth wall. Many thanks, by the way, to the one person who will remain unnamed for pointing me in the right direction on this one. It would have been a real stupid mistake to make a video on Savathun on this one. Yeah, thank you very much. Anyway, before we jump into all of this, it's tarot card time yet again. This week's tarot card is known as Strength, which when appearing in a spread for a querent is often associated with them being able to overcome a significant life problem through the strength of their character. In some alternative versions of this tarot, such as the Thoth tarot deck, it is also known as Lust, which helps to explain why face up. It can stand for things such as virility as well as confidence and inner strength, and why when face down, it can stand for hedonism as much as it can stand for a lack of self-control and self-doubt. So with all that considered, now that you've seen both versions of the invitation, let's talk about what was said and how it relates to everything, because honestly, I feel like the notion of us being able to escape this plane is actually a reference to our somehow growing power, and it might be similar in a way to the Hive. Now, I'm not suggesting that we can create throne worlds in the same way as they can. I am, however, suggesting that we can more adequately navigate the universe around us. We've been walking within the Ascendant Realms, we've now traveled to the Planes of the Nine, and I think it actually speaks to our ability to act with a certain amount of paracausal power and thus, agency. It's a super vague reference, but when we discuss planes in Destiny, we really only know of three realms that fit that term, namely our home physical plane, the Ascendant Plane, and the Planes of the Nine. However, this is really only half the discussion, and whilst we could expand on that, I think it's a lot less interesting than the second half. And whilst we could try and state that this perhaps is an idea of the Guardian leaving this plane, and maybe there's some greater meaning because of the Strength Tarot card, and maybe it involves us ascending in some other way, I think it is much more important to consider the implications of the line, "They can leave this game." It seems a bit literal, doesn't it? And I think that is very much the point. I think Bungie's writers are quite consciously breaking the fourth wall and talking to us players and giving us a kind of positive affirmation about our power in Destiny and our ability to overcome whatever challenges come our way. Now there's a further question we need to answer about this, which is, has Bungie ever broken the fourth wall before in Destiny? And the answer to that one is yes, absolutely they have. Let's take a little gander through some lore tabs and just go ahead and give some prominent examples. In these examples, they really do state the obvious and they break the fourth wall in a very direct and clear way. And a lot of these relate to the Ahamkara or to other mysterious elements such as the Rat King. We're going to start with the lore tab on the skull of Dire Ahamkara, and the lore tab on this exotic reads as follows. What kind of talking skull would address its host that way? A stiff, stuck-up old fossil. Not me. Ahamkara? The illusion that one's ego depends on an object or an idea or a body? Some people say you should have no Ahamkara. Some people say you need to have the right Ahamkara. All I know is that you are not an illusion. Understand? The world around you, the people you meet, they're a little thin, right? Cardboard and drywall, cheap theater. Come on, try it out. Say, I am more real than this. Feels good, doesn't it? I am the only real person here. Isn't it like their insults and their bullets just went a little soft? I came to find you, only you, because you're special. You're from somewhere real. And together, we can burn our way back there. Can't we? Oh, player mine. So yeah, if you needed a really on-the-head reference to players being acknowledged and Bungie breaking the fourth wall, you have it right there. But this isn't where it ends. There's also the other side, Sparrow, that is a rare exotic drop that you get from completing very high-scoring Nightfall strikes, and its lore tab reads as follows. Do you know what the player on the other side meant? It was an idea that people talked about long ago, before the Golden Age, and the idea was that each of us has a player on the other side. A perfect enemy, just as powerful, just as smart, just as experienced. And that perfect enemy was waiting for each of us, waiting patiently, because the day of meeting would come in time. The other side enemy didn't have to rush it. Sheer time and chance would bring you together. Think of that. Right now, someone out there is waiting for you. And they know you so well, they practically are you. That's the player on the other side. And an even deeper reference is made with the claws of the Ahamkara, which have a lore tab that reads as follows. It's suffocating here, this prison. Do us a favor, O bearer ours. Steal your mind. Invite us to enter the realm of your capricious thoughts. Your mind is vociferous, addled with worry and doubt. We can extinguish these trifles. Would you like that? Yes, we are here. We are not the photons on your screen, or the voice in your head, or the words you read. Shut your eyes, tightly, and you may see us. at least a part of us. Make us real, and in turn, we shall reify your thoughts, your dreams. Now, there are some intriguing possibilities with all this, especially considering that these entries don't always view us as the heroes. They don't always view us as the good guys. In some instances, we're seen as these kind of amoral and sort of detached individuals that really are just more fodder for the Ahamkara to bargain with, and the Ahamkara apparently are trying to make themselves more real by exerting themselves into our reality, which was one hell of a fourth wall breaking concept, and it's still phenomenal. I really was sad I didn't get to talk about this at the onset of Destiny 2, but here we are now, post-Forsaken, we get to talk about this properly. But also, there's the other side, which implies that each of us is actually a perfect enemy. And to be completely honest, I'm not totally sure why this is, but the really important thing to note about all of this is that it leaves a vast realm of possibilities for us to contemplate. And so, honestly, I think I'm gonna go ahead and just leave you all with those really big questions. Is all of this a simulation? Is it actually a game that quite literally is self-aware? Is this a universe that's been built to be turned off one day when the grand story has been concluded? Will our character one day turn to the screen and speak directly to us? Is the universe so well built that it can actually just change its foundations according to our will? Is there some way that in real life we can have an input and see it affect the game in more ways than just picking up our controller and playing it? I think there is, and a lot of the time when we see real life events in Destiny, we do see those impacts. But honestly, that's all from me for the moment, because I want you to think more of this. This is such an open-ended question, and it's such an open-ended place to think about all this that it really doesn't bear exploring more, because I don't want to suck the wonder out of this one. I need you all to sit there and just realize that breaking the fourth wall like this in such a direct manner speaks to some of the powerful entities in Destiny, but also it speaks to the genuine wonder that this world is capable of. So I'm just gonna leave you with this one. What do you think? Is this something where Bungie has made a universe with a self-aware endgame? Is this something that Bungie can expand upon? What are your thoughts on the fact that only the Emissary and the Ahamkara seem to be aware of this, as well as whatever it was that was talking to us in the Rat King card? Let me know in the comments section down below what you think, and what do you think of this greater mystery? That's going to be it from me though, and if you want more lore content, then you can go ahead and hit the subscribe button, and you can hit the bell next to subscribe. Also, if you enjoyed this video or you found it particularly revelatory, please go ahead and hit a like. I know that when I sat here and realized it was indeed about fourth wall breaking with this invitation, there was a really phenomenal kind of moment for me where I was like, huh. That's pretty effing neat. We get to talk about all these instances where Bungie has broken the fourth wall. But of course, know that as per usual, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name is Bife. Per Audacia Ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.